Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to learn reactive programming internal workflow. But before going to write the code, first we need to understand its theory and internal steps that will execute while write the code. In our previous video, we have already discussed about what is reactive programming and why we need to use reactive programming. So today in this video, we will discuss about reactive programming specification and we will create one small program to understand its internal workflow. Okay, let's start with theory first. So these are the four main interfaces of reactive stream. First is publisher, that is used to publish an event. And second is subscriber, that is used to subscribe an event. And third is subscription. And fourth is processor. So we will understand one by one each interface. So we will start with the first interface, that is publisher. So publisher is a data source who will always publish an event. And this interface contain only one method, that is subscribe. And if subscriber want to interact with publisher, then he need to invoke this method, that is subscribe. And inside subscribe method, we need to pass the parameter of subscriber. And the second interface is subscriber. And here we can see subscriber interface contains four methods. First is onSubscribe. Second is onNext, third onError, and fourth is onComplete. And the subscriber will subscribe or consume the events from publisher. And for every data transfer between publisher to subscriber, onNext event will be executed. So this is the onNext event. If all the data transfer successfully, then onComplete event will be executed. But while processing of records, if there is any error or exception occurred in our code, then onError event will be executed. So that we will understand through code later. And the third interface is subscription. Subscription represents the unique relationship between a subscriber and publisher. And it mainly contains two methods, that is request method, that contains long n as a parameter, and second is cancel method. And we will try to understand all these methods in its internal workflow while writing the code. And the fourth interface, that is processor. A processor represents a processing stage which is both a subscriber and a publisher, and it must obey the contract of both. So here we can see processor has extends two interfaces. First one is subscriber and second is publisher. Okay, let's start try to understand the flow between all interfaces. So here we can see step by step. So first subscriber will invoke subscribe method of publisher, and inside this method he is passing the instance of subscriber. So only publisher and subscriber can interact with each other. And in the next step, publisher is going to send a subscription event to the subscriber and confirm that your subscription is successfully by passing the parameter as subscription instance. And in the third steps, subscriber will call request method of subscription interface, and it will get the data from publisher. So here in request we can see one parameter, that is n. Here n means subscriber is requesting for n number of records to publish. So while sending the request by subscriber to publisher, n means how many number of records subscriber is expecting from publisher. Then publisher will send data streams to subscriber by invoking onNext method. So here let's take one example. Here we can assume publisher is going to send hundreds of records to subscriber. Then in that case, publisher will call 100 times on next method. And once all the 100 records are received by the subscriber, then publisher will invoke on complete method. But in any case, while sending the 100 records from publisher to subscriber, if any error occurred while processing the data, then on error event will execute. Then on complete will not execute if error will occur. But if everything is executed successfully and received by subscriber, then on complete event will execute. So now we will try to understand again how publisher and subscriber interact with each other and what libraries they used. So reactive programming libraries is Reactor, RxJava, and third is JDK 9 Flow Reactive Stream. In our example, we are going to use Project Reactor, and it is a recommended library to work with Spring Boot framework. And the Project Reactor data type, here we can see that is Mono and Flux. These are two data types. Mono is used to support only single element. If we have list of element, then we can use Flux, because Flux can support n number of elements, but Mono can support only single element. These are the two data types. To understand more about this data type, we will create one small program to understand, and we will see how reactive programming workflow internally work. So let's start. First, I will create one simple Spring Boot reactive project. So here first I will type start.spring.io, and here we just need to define project type Maven project, language Java, and Spring Boot version 2.5.4, and here we need to define group ID com.gain.java.knowledge, and here we need to define artifact ID Spring Boot Web Flux Demo. And next we need to add the dependencies, and also need to use which version we want to use for Java. Click on add dependency, and here I will search for Spring Reactive Web. So here we just need to add one dependency. Now I will click on generate. Extract it here. Now go to our Eclipse, which ID that we want to use, we can use. So here I will just import. Click on existing Maven project and import my project, that is Spring Boot Web Flux Demo. So here I will just open it. It's taking time to import. So now after importing the project into workspace, now I will go to my test folder, and here I will just create one class, new class, and here we just need to define the class name Reactive Programming Workflow Test. So as we know, there are two data types supported by reactive programming. One is Mono and second is Flux. So here I will do method. Here first I will create one method to test our Mono data type. Public void Mono test. And as we know, Mono can handle only one element, so we will create Mono object first. So here what I will do, Mono dot just function that we need to call. So here I will just call Mono dot just, and here we need to pass data type. We can pass any type of data. Here I am just passing integer data type and assigning the variable just int. So now what I will do here, subscriber need to invoke on subscribe method. So once a subscriber will invoke subscribe method, then it can get the event from publisher only. So here I will just call subscribe method. And here I need to pass the instance system.of subscriber println. So now I will execute this test first. Run as Java application. So here we can see the output on console, that is 1 was printed, but we do not know its event was executed or not. Here we saw there are 4 events used by subscriber: on next, on error, on complete. But here in code we not able to see which events going to execute. So here we just need to call log method, then we can check the events also. So after adding this method, I will run this test again. Run as junit test. So here we can see events also. First, on subscribe event was executed. After that, request was executed. And third, on next. And fourth, after successful completion of everything, on complete event was executed. So this was a complete flow, like we can check here. First on subscribe, then request, after that on next. So this was the flow. If successfully everything executed, then on complete event was executed. But if there is any exception occurred while processing the data, then on complete will not execute, and at the place of on complete, here on error event will execute. Okay, let's see. So here we just need to call then mono.error. mono.error, and here we need to just throw the exception, new runtime exception, and here we can pass any string, and here we need to change generic because its return type will be the object. So now I will run this test case again and will check this time on complete event will be executed or on error event will execute. As we know, in case of error, must be on error event will execute. So run this unit test. So here on console we will check it. So here we can see the flow. First on subscribe event was executed, after that request, but after that on error event was executed, and on next and on complete error was not executed, event was not executed. So like this, if we want to support only single element, then we can use mono. If we want to support multiple element, then we can go for flux, that is another data type of reactive programming. So here I will use flux. Flux, and flux is used to support multiple elements. So first I will execute, run this test only, that is flux test, and we'll check the output, how many events will execute. So So as we know, if we have four records, then four events of onNext will execute. Means onNext method will execute four times because we have four items here. So I will just run this unit test case. And here we can see on the console, first onNext method executed for first event, second onNext executed for second event, third onNext for third element, and fourth onNext for fourth element. And after completing successful, everything was executed successfully, onComplete event was executed. So this is the internal workflow of Spring Boot Webflux. So here we can also throw exception and check when the onError event will be executed. So if we want to execute onError event, then we must need to throw exception from here again. So here I will just call the function concat with, and inside concat with I just need to throw the error forcefully flux error, and here we just need to throw the exception. So now we will check what event will be executed. Now as we know, if error will occur while processing the data, then onError event will execute. Now onComplete event will not execute because we are throwing exception forcefully. So here we will check the console. In case of error, first onNext one, then onNext second time, third time, fourth time, but after that onComplete was not executed, and here we can see onError event was executed due to exception. So this is all about reactive streaming internal workflow. In next video we will create one real-time example and see how it is working. Okay, thanks for watching this video.